Now, why are there three kingdoms? Just to go to that before we go to the seven levels. Yeah? Now, remember one thing. The pattern is common. So, the levels are common in all the kingdoms. Yeah? What is different in each kingdom is the way the person perceives their life situation and the way the person perceives their problem. When a person perceives their problem as something that they have to correct, they have to change, they have to work upon, they do not have the capacity for and they have to improve. So they are focusing on their own capacity or adequacy or inadequacy, whatever. And they are focusing on how to reach their target. It could be whatever level. But their focus for their problem or even their problem they feel is something from within which they need to change. When a patient has that vision of his problem, not vision, that view.
View, outlook.
That outlook towards his problem and towards his life. Then in that moment, he needs a mineral remedy. But when a patient has the outlook or the view that he is dependent on others around to solve his situation, to solve his conflict, to give him security, or he feels that others are restricting him from his freedom, from what he really wants to do. So what I'm telling you here is when a patient is looking outside either for a solution or for a reason to blame, then he needs in that moment an animal remedy of the same level. If you see in your patient, there is a lot of conflict. A lot of conflict between what they want to do, but what is expected out of them by the people around them. And there is a constant struggle between them and their chemistry between people around them. I'm telling you, believe me, even if they sound like a mineral, give an animal, the mineral will not help. This is from several cases of failure that I'm coming to this. Several cases of failure which then improved on animal remedies. At that point, I also know when I'm on an animal remedy, let me just tell you a little bit more. You know, recently or in the last 5 or 6 years, we have, of course, because we worked on the whole map of animals and made, you know, very clear maps and stages and levels, and, you know, we've brought out the whole plethora of animal remedies. Somebody was just recently asking me, do you only prescribe animal remedies? And I said, no. But I do see that there is a lot of prevalence of animal remedies which we didn't know of earlier. The reason is because we didn't know about them. And also, we didn't know that this was the aspect of an animal remedy, which I learned now through my cases, and now that my eyes are open, I see more and more of this aspect of conflict and struggle. And believe me, when there is so much conflict and struggle, then you need an animal remedy. But I would also like to tell you one more thing. When we see a lot of people today, we see a lot of struggle. Most people come up with conflicts and struggle in their day-to-day lives. And it is our conflicts and struggles that are giving rise to our problems. No wonder, therefore, we see a lot of animal remedies. Another important thing also is that we also see a lot of plant remedies today, especially with the help of our map. So the more the homeopath knows, the more the homeopath is able to see. I could earlier pick up minerals, you know, 90% of our practice was minerals, and we only taught minerals for the first few years of our life, and I thought 60 to 80% of anybody's practice would be minerals, because I could see minerals well. See, what is important is the level is common between the plant, the mineral and the animal. Later came a time when I got introduced to imponderables, introduced through my patients. The patients brought up symptoms, the patient brought up, you know, certain things which weren't fitting into any remedies. We started using imponderables, and then the whole Pandora's box of imponderables and nozobes came out. And I said, once you understand, I could spot more imponderables and nozobes, both Shachindra and me. Then we came to animals. And we could then see the animal in everyone.
And believe me, we came to animals thanks to our friends and colleagues in America, in a place where we felt it was a mineral and they felt it was an animal. And the whole argument and debate, and then the whole animal state came out. So you see, you are open to see what's coming out. And then once you get introduced, you realize and you see that truth, and then the whole Pandora's box just unfolds.
Today we are also working on our plant maps, and we can now spot the plants as well. What am I trying to say? The more open I am, the more I understand the plant in that level, the mineral in that level, and the animal in that level, the more I'm able to see. So today Shachindra and I are at a point where in a case sitting in front of us, we can see the plant of that level, we can see the mineral of that level, and we can see the animal of that level clearly. Then we decide, but does this patient need at the moment the plant, the moment the animal, or the mineral? Because in that moment the patient needs only one. But because being a homeopath who's now understood the levels and understood the common pattern between the three, we can see it. And this often happens in your cases too, don't you think? You feel, this looks a little bit like sulfur, but this also looks a little bit like lyco. That's because lycopodium is also level 3 and sulfur is also level 3.
Any one of them will work.
Any one of them will work, but in the moment, which one will work? The question is, which kingdom you need? And which level? But more important than the kingdom, what we've realized in the last few years of our practice, after bringing all of these on one map, we realized what's most important is to get the level right. Because once you get the level right, then whichever kingdom, you will be able to make some change. And then it is only the matter of moving between one kingdom to another. And as you read our books or go through our, you know, monthly tonics or, you know, webinars or seminars, I'm also telling you there are so many free ones already loaded up. As you go through all of that, you will see that it's not difficult. You will see that the levels completely come from the rubrics and the symptoms, and you can completely understand and you can connect why bryonia is in level 5, why rustox is in, bryonia is in level 4, rustox is in level 5, or stramonium is in level 6, or why is lachesis in level 7, but naja in level 6, or, you know, etc., etc. It's really very simple.
And it makes more sense in your prescription. Because many a time what happens is that the remedy that is thrown out through a repertoire in totality or any process gives you a particular remedy, and then you have to find a way why could this remedy be applicable, and then you use your own logic. But when you can systematically come to a particular level and see that these are the group of remedies over there, and then you see a remedy on your screen, you realize the significance and the connection and the groundedness based on which you make a prescription. Otherwise it becomes the best person is able to select a remedy, can get the cure, and the rest can't, which is not the case. Make a standard and then explore that level.
Absolutely. So what is level? Okay, now we come to, we've explained you our whole concept. We now come to what is levels. Yeah? See, remember one thing. Each one of us, yeah, when you look at yourself, even before you go to the patient, inquire with yourself. We all want to reach a certain point. We all have aspirations. We all have goals. We all have something that we are constantly wanting out of ourselves and out of our life, and we are working towards it. Or not working towards it and complaining. That is another story. But we all have a certain goal or aspiration. We all have a story. A story of our past, a story of our present, and a dream of our future. All of this put together gives me the level. So our level is basically, yeah, our level is basically where we want to be in our lives. Now someone might already be there, someone might be wanting to be there, someone might be there but be complaining of not being happy there. That doesn't matter. What matters is, what is this aspiration or goal or place that you are stuck in? That is the level of the patient. Okay? How he sees this level, yeah, how he perceives is the kingdom. Like I said, within that goal, if you are working towards it, you're a mineral. If you are looking for the chemistry and the struggle and the conflict between you and others around in this level, you are the animal. The plant, I forgot to mention the plant before going to the level. The plant patient or plant remedies, A, definitely have very clear physical symptoms, I would say. They have very clear physical modalities and sensations. But that's not it. The plant individuals are people who are more complex. You know, they are even more complex in a way to understand than the animals. Animals are complex too, but they have such a creative, they have such a clear conflict that they are easy to pick up for a homeopath. The plants are more complex in a way that they have several levels, not just one. Yeah, that's why we are going to take the plants in the end, because they are the most complex one to understand. Okay? Not an evolution, but more for understanding. So they have several levels, one. Second important thing is, they feel everything as overwhelming. They don't have a conflict with the outside. They don't have a conflict that this is what they want and this is what I want and how do I manage my chemistry. No. They have an overwhelming feeling. This is what everything happens. This is how everything behaves with me. And then this is how I react, and I have no option but to react. So they are very overwhelmed by any situation. Yeah? Another important thing I've often seen also is that when we've given an animal remedy and there is that one niggling symptom which does not, you know, everything is better, all is fine, the conflict is better, the patient is feeling more free, but there is that one physical niggling symptom, I actually give a plant of that level. And it makes a very good, you know, result for that physical symptom. Now, Once I've explained you, okay, so coming back, the level is very important. The level that the patient is living in, is he complex and overwhelmed? Then he's a plant. Is he working towards it and he's thinking that he himself must make the efforts for his level? then he's a mineral. And if he has a conflict with the outside, then he's an animal of that level. And then, once you know the level and the animal, then you go within that map of the animal kingdom to find out which animal. Once you know the level and it's a plant, then you go within the map of the plant to find out which plant belongs to that level. And similarly, you go within the mineral kingdom to find out which mineral belongs to that level. Then the map from that point on gets more and more detailed. We will leave that for other sessions. But this was a basic idea.